Hey everyone, if you haven't seen any of my other YouTube videos, I'd like to introduce myself. I'm Sarah Hornsby, and I am a myofunctional therapist in Seattle. I have a really popular YouTube video about how to unblock your nose in 5 minutes, so I decided to make a follow-up video of how to stop mouth breathing and having an open mouth in 5 easy steps. Okay, so step one, the first thing you need to do is determine if the reason you're breathing through your mouth is because you can't, like it's a reaction to something, your nose is stuffed up so you can't do it, or it's a habit. So a habit is much easier to fix. I work with patients every day and I help them learn new habits so they can learn to breathe through their nose. So that's good if it's a habit. If it is a reaction, so it's a reaction to not being able to breathe, then that means you have to figure out why. So the first step is just determining, is it a habit or is it a reaction? So how can you do that? Well, there's one easy test that I always have my patients do, and that is I want you to get a timer or a stopwatch or the thing on your phone and time yourself for 2 minutes and see if you can breathe through your nose for 2 minutes at a time. That's the first thing you can do. If it's difficult, if you can't do it, that means there's a reason that your nose is stuffed up and it's not a habit to breathe through your mouth. It's actually a reaction. Okay, step number two. The second thing you need to do is figure out if you're allergic to anything. So there are 3 D's, as I call them, of things that people are commonly allergic to, and that would be dust, dairy, and dander. These are 3 big things that can cause a lot of problems. So if you can determine if you're allergic to any of these things, it can be really, really helpful in getting you to stop breathing through your mouth. One of the ways I recommend doing this is either eliminating them from your diet. Try for 30 days. Say, I'm not going to eat any milk or any cheese for 30 days. You could try not letting your pet sleep in the bed to try to eliminate some of the dander, and try doing that for 30 days. If you really want a definitive answer, I recommend that you go get an allergy test to determine if you're allergic to something and that's the reason that your nose is getting all blocked up. Okay, the third thing you need to do is figure out if you have large tonsils. So our tonsils are in the back of our throat. If you open really wide and say, ah, you should be able to see them. If you have large tonsils, you actually have a more difficult time breathing through your nose because your tonsils are taking up some of your airway space in your throat. Another part of tonsils are called adenoids. So there is tonsillar tissue called our adenoids, and it's right behind our nose in our throat. So you can't actually see if you have enlarged adenoids. But what I always recommend is that you find out if you have large tonsils or large adenoids, and that's the reason that you can't breathe through your nose. Okay, so how can you do that? Well, there are 2 ways. You can either just try looking in the mirror, open your mouth wide, say ah, and look on the sides of your throat and see if you have any like tonsil bulges like you can see in the picture here. See if you have that sticking out the side. And on this tonsil grading scale that I've provided, you can determine if your tonsils are size 3 or size 4. And those are the sizes when I consider them to be a problem. The second way you can do it is to go visit an ENT. That's an ear, nose, and throat doctor. Those doctors can help you know because they have a scope. They can use a scope or they can use an x-ray and they can determine if you have large tonsils or large adenoids, and that's the reason behind your mouth breathing. Okay, so step four. The fourth thing you can do to determine or to learn how to stop mouth breathing is determine where your tongue is resting. So it's going to be a lot harder to close your mouth and to breathe through your nose if your tongue's in the wrong place. But where should your tongue be? It should always be resting in the top of your mouth, so up here. It should not be resting down here. But if you're sitting here thinking, oh no, my tongue is in the bottom of my mouth, that means you have a habit called a tongue thrust. And that is actually what I work with people to get rid of and to learn how to train their tongue to swallow the right way, chew, drink, eat, and even breathe the right way with your tongue on the roof of your mouth. So step four is to figure out where is your tongue resting. Okay, the fifth and final recommendation that I have to learn how you can stop breathing through your mouth or keeping your mouth open when you're resting is to learn how to unblock your nose. So I have a video, watch my video on how to unblock your nose through doing a breathing exercise, and that's really, really helpful. But there are other ways to do it. Of course, you can always take medication. You can use nasal sprays. You can take allergy medication like Benadryl. Anything you can do so that your nose is easier to breathe through can help you a lot. The other thing I like to recommend that you can give a try, see if it works for you, is a neti pot. And you can find those online or in pharmacies, but basically any method you can find to be able to breathe through your nose will help you close your mouth.